Okay. My name's Graham Prentice, and I guess you could say I'm a painter. I've been just painting for a long ass time, so that's what I love to do. I've been like painting since I was a little kid. For as far back as I remember, my house always had like art supplies and everything scattered around. So my family is in architecture and like the sort of like visual lifestyle. It's just like always been hella important to me. So I guess in the modern context, like I have just been trying to take that to the next level for me, and just like it's sort of my way of like mitigating or reconciling like all the influences like that I and we like collectively as a people experience today, and sort of compile everything and deal with it and pick the aesthetic forces that are most powerful to me and recombine them, I guess. So basically, what I'm trying to go for is to take the like entire diversity of human experience and distill from it, like what, from an aesthetic, moral, or philosophical standpoint, means the most to me, and just in terms of the pure, sort of like artistic component of that. I love oils, man. You can't be oil paint for like that like rich feeling, but like the fact is acrylic is just so much easier to use, and they invented this stuff recently that like you can add to your acrylic paint to like give it that same kind of rich texture as the oil has. Obviously it's not the same, but like just acrylic dries really fast, so you can like just build up in layers really quickly, whereas oil you're just like constantly working with it, and it's more frustrating, I think, in that way, because I'm sort of impatient. Like, when I want to get going, you just got to go, you know? So, like, yeah, so paint, definitely, like, a lot of, like paint pens, ink, like, India ink, Sharpie, marker, whatever you want, spray paint, stencils, newspaper, oh, yeah, definitely, like combining media. That cat Rauschenberg is like one of my favorites for sure. I'll show you some funky shit, dude. Graffiti in its essence is like the, even if it's like, you know, just pure vandalism, it's just like this expression of like human emotion and like the response to it's a response to life. And even if it's not, even if it's just pure self-aggrandizement, it's still at least creative in some form, you know? And I don't really dig the like straight vandalism, name writing shit, but like when it gets to like the construction of art on like the urban surface, like starts coming up in cities, on buildings and billboards, and on trains that just like get sent out on tracks in and out of the cities, and like you get this like interwoven network of just like visual media that's just completely democratic. It's just like it just comes down to the people who are creating it in that impulse, in that moment, and no one can stop them. So I definitely respect that. And then just color, man, like color, that's like sort of like one of our few, that's like the beauty of being a painter, man, is just like when it comes down to like just a single choice, right? I mean, it's line and color, like what, I mean, you got your forms and then like, what are you about to make them look like? Like you have the entire infinite spectrum available to you, so. You know, it's like those conscious choices, it's like an allegory for just your, just like everyday life, you know? You got, you know, an infinite array of choices in front of you. You get to, you have, you know, supposedly we have free will. So like, what are you about to do with that? You get to create yourself, create your idea, create your identity, create your reality. And this is like just a perfect, like tangible manifestation of that. And like this, like, mind-blowing, like, visual sort of experience. So. Roll me, baby, like you roll a wagon wheel. I want you to roll me, baby. Painting for my entire life, so let's do this.